Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. I hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving day. We certainly did. We were at my brother's house in Louisville, and there were lots and lots of people, all family, and it was great to get together with them, and the food was wonderful. And I didn't even bring a dish. I was told that I didn't need to, and they provided all the food, and the food was just excellent. I couldn't begin to name everything that we had. There was so much food. What I want to tell you is that I was in the middle of doing a few uploads with regard to a restaurant that we had eaten at recently, which was Hangers in Richmond, Kentucky. And you had a few more requests, and I wanted to finish those up. So in this next week, probably every other day or so, I will be uploading recipes like those that we had at Hangers Restaurant. So I hope you will enjoy those. There were some things that were fairly unique, and I really wanted to do them for you, but with Thanksgiving on its way, I felt like I had to put those aside and do Thanksgiving dinner for you, and then I decided to get back to those at this point. So I hope you will enjoy them. In the meantime, I did make a few mistakes while I was working on Thanksgiving dinner, so I have a few bloopers that are on this particular video, and if you just continue to watch, you'll see me make a lot of blunders. Now, I had them in the oven for, Here we have our... I let them bake at 400 degrees for 15 minutes. No, that's not right. These dressing balls just came straight from the oven, and I baked them at 375 for 10 minutes. Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making slow cooker green beans seasoned with ham. And this is a suggestion for your Thanksgiving table. I like to have a couple of green vegetables, and then maybe something that's orange or yellow, and then some starchy things, and then some kind of meat or poultry, and also sweets belong there as well. So sometimes my Thanksgiving table has more on it than I would have for a normal dinner. We don't eat that much, but we expect to have a little treat when it is a holiday season, so I try to plan things that will go well for our family. I don't like any. And then we need to boil it for 5 minutes. And then when it's boiled 5 minutes, we'll bring it off the heat and we'll start doing something with our carrots. In the meantime, we'll prepare our carrots. Oh, let me do that again. We'll be boiling this. What I have done is, just to make it easier, I cut it in half, and then each one of these I cut in half, and they want to roll around a little bit, so you just have to be careful with your hands and everything. And I try to hit the center. That's kind of in my way. If you want two equal pieces, then just go down the center, and then you can hold those together and get your pieces as you choose. So here's what you'll see after you have beaten your cream cheese. Now, you may use fat-free or regular cream cheese. And then we're going to thin it down a little bit. So we're going to add in 1/4 cup of milk. That can be any kind of milk that you like to use. And we don't want it to splash, so we'll start really slowly. It's going to splash anyway. Okay, they won't see that. This should be good. Lovely flavor. If you like these three items, and that's really just, you can turn it off. If you like these three items, which mainly would be spinach, if it's fixed with something, I don't like it myself cooked. I like it raw, but, start again. If you like these three items, which would be spinach, and then the cream cheese and also the Parmesan cheese. Before I leave the chicken stock to sit and cool, I'm going to add a little more flavor, and what I'm using is instant bouillon, and it says chicken flavor, so you can get them in different flavors. What we're going to use are 2 teaspoons, and I have it measured out here. So, the butter that I have right here is 1/3 cup. So I think that corresponds with something like 5 1/3 tablespoons. You can check on that, but it's marked on a stick of butter where you have 1/3 cup. So we need 1/3 cup. And you need it cold. So bring it right from the refrigerator and don't let it sit on the counter for a long time. A lot of times we need it softened, but when you're cutting it into flour or cake mix or something like that, you want to maintain those little bits of butter. You don't want them to mash in with the flour making a dough. You want to maintain the little balls that will occur as we use a pastry blender. So this is a little difficult since I got it stuck there on the very first try, but I'm going to blend this up and it will come out like coarse cornmeal. And when it gets to that point, we'll continue with our recipe. I have let my two cakes, but honestly, the sauce that I was using was warm enough that these needed to sit for a while in order to really hold together. But I think it was still a good idea to put it on put the marshmallow mixture in when. And our most